Hello, welcome back to my channel. Today we are discussing a topic that has been very requested, a brush video, and kind of explaining what brushes I use, how I use them, and maybe why I use them. I have realized now, after lots of brush buying and accumulating, you don't need a ton of brushes. You just need the ones that are gonna get the job done, and that's it. So these are the ones that I use. There are obviously other alternatives, but these are just the ones I use. They're very affordable, and yeah, I mean, I did this pretty intense eye with the brushes that I used, and you can also use them as a more natural look. So yeah, let's just get right on into it. Okay, so I always apply my foundation with a damp beauty blender. I wet mine every time before I use it. So I clean it with a bar of Dove soap, squeeze it under the water like 15-20 times, and then wring it out in my towel, and then it's just nice and damp. I prefer this just because it feels good, and even though like a brush can give you a more full coverage look, I just prefer a beauty blender. I like the feeling of it, and I just like the way that they apply better. So you guys have all seen me do this. I just tap tap tap, pat it into my face, and then also I will take my Mario Badescu spray just to kind of re-dampen it, tap it out on my hand a little bit so it's not super wet, and then just re-blend. This just gives you a nice, like, natural, flawless look. Okay, so I don't cream contour often, but if I do, depending on the product I use, I will use a stippling brush like this and just kind of swirl and blend the product out, or a beauty blender, and that's what I'm gonna use today. And I just, same as foundation and concealer, just pat it into the skin. Really gonna blend it out. Okay, and then to set my under eyes, you can use a brush. I used to use a brush, but I like to use my beauty blender when it's still damp and re-blend out my under eyes first of all, because it's been sitting for a minute. And I do like to let it sit after I let it blend it out, because it kind of lets it crease, if that makes sense. And then I re-blend it and then set it. You guys have seen me do this in like all of my videos, but I'll just take my spray again, tap 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 tap, and blendy blend, and then take my translucent powder, dip, and I don't bake, I just pat it in to my skin. The brushes that I'm using below as well, but most of my brushes are e.l.f. or Morphe or Real Techniques. So this is just an e.l.f. brush. It's a blush brush, but I use it to set the rest of my face with my powder, and just tapping this into the skin. For bronzer, I use an e.l.f. blush brush as well. I think this is like an older one. It looks old, you can tell. So it's a little worn out and like fluffy, which I like. But yeah, I just like the way this applies it. And then to bake, I just use my translucent powder, damp beauty blender again, and get a lot of product on there. like to bake under my bronze, contour, whatever, just because it cleans it up a little bit, and not because I want like a harsh contour. I just think it separates my bronzer from my, like, I feel like sometimes I go too low, so it'll help like make that separated and give me a little bit more definition. Okay, now moving on to the eyes. So I'm gonna do a really basic eye look, showing you like the essential brushes that I use that I feel like you need, and that's it. So first and foremost, you need a fluffy blending brush. This is a Morphe one. I recommend Morphe brushes. They're very affordable, and they're really good. So, and it's like, once you get these brushes, you don't really have to purchase them again unless you want to, or, you know, they're really old, because you just clean them and take care of them and you have them forever. So I feel like it's worth it buying the brushes you need, because it truly makes a difference. So this brush I just use to put an all-over color on my eyelid, like a transition shade. So I'm just using the 3502 palette, and it's just a nice subtle color. I also forgot to contour my nose, and I usually use my bronzer, and since that color was about the same as my bronzer, we're just gonna do this real quick. But I don't like a super harsh nose contour, so just add color to my nose, like I've said before. Let me just go down the nose with this brush usually. I don't know. Back to a regular scheduled programming. I'm gonna do something orangey. So I'm using the same brush and just picking up this orange shade and putting it in my crease. So this brush is just used for like your all over high crease color, I would say. Going orangey. And I always just keep this brush handy because I use it to go back and blend. Okay, the next brush I use is also a Morphe brush. The first one was Morphe M511. This one is M441. It's still a fluffy brush, just a little denser. And this is what I use for my crease color. So now we're going to go in with a little more burnt orangey shade right in the crease with this. So right where your eye crease is, we do this. And just windshield wiper motions back and forth. Blendy blend. And then I just literally keep these two brushes handy and just go back and forth. This is the fluffier brush, the M511. Just making sure it's really blended out. And you know, if I want more of that orange or tan color, I'll pick it up on my brush. Just reapply it. And then I just go back and forth, and I'm back with the M411. Until I get it the way I want it. Alright, so that's pretty much how I want it. And now for the under eye. First, I go in with like a transition shade for my under eye, and I use this e.l.f. eyeshadow brush. It looks like this. And I'll pick up that first, like, barely anything shade just to get a color under there. And I like this brush just because it gets the job done. It just puts that overall color. Okay, and now I'm going in with the orangey shade on the same brush. I just clean them after I use colors like this. Getting a little fallout, so I'm just gonna brush it off with my face brush. Really going in with the orange. And then I use a Morphe M432 brush, looks like this, to kind of get a little bit closer to my lash line. And I'm gonna be using that burnt orange shade just at the outer corner. So I just basically use the same shades I did on my lid. Ooh, she is orange. And then if I wanted to add another color to like the outer corner to make it a little bit more smoky, I would use this brush. It is a Morphe M503. And I'll just go ahead and show you why not. I would just take a little bit deeper of a shade and just literally pat it in this outer corner to give it more of like a smoky effect. And then if you, you know, want to keep adding the color, you would just add more and then blend it out. Okay. But I want this to be like really orange, so I don't really want that color, but I just wanted to show you. And then you can either just apply a regular shadow, or if you're extra like me and you want a shimmery shade, that's what we're doing. I just use my good old finger, usually my ring finger, and I just swirl it around into the pigment. And just literally pat it onto my eye. I could have done a cut crease for this, but it's okay. You guys have seen me do a cut crease before. Ooh, this is orange. I love it. When you use like a pigment with a brush, I just don't feel like it goes on well. In certain situations, I'll use a brush and then I like wet it with my Mario Badescu spray, but this is usually my jam. That's amazing. Okay, so now we're hopping right back to the face. Sorry that I'm kind of hopping around. But I like to let this sit and then do my eyes and then come back to my face. That's just my jam. However you do it is how you do it, girl. I'm going to brush off my bake with this fluffy Real Techniques brush. And it kind of helps blend everything out as well. And I just realized I look like Halloween or Bingles, whichever you want to consider it. But I'm not wearing this shirt today, I just threw it on. Okay, next we're gonna apply blush, and I use this Real Techniques blush brush. It's a good one. And I just tap it into the product and then just right on the front of my cheeks place the product. And I like to put blush all over, so I put it on my nose and then I will just put it down me. Just, I don't know why, it's just what I do. And now I'm setting my face with my Prime and Fine spray. This is good to just set all your powders. And then I like it because it will make your highlight a little bit more intense. I'm going to highlight my inner corner. And you can use your finger. I've done that a million times. I use this small eyeshadow brush. It's a Sephora brush that I just got in like a pack. But you can definitely get them on Morphe or use your finger, just as good. And just apply that to the inner corner, the nose a little bit, hit the Cupid's bow a little bit. And then for overall highlight, I use two different brushes. Depends on my mood. The Morphe M501 this or the Morphe M438. Looks like this. I'll show you each side with a different brush. So this one, you want to make sure your face is dry, or if it's damp, just pat it. But my face is dry, so I'm gonna swirl it. I feel like this gives you a more natural highlight, and this I like use to pat. So if I want a more intense highlight, I use that. Brush it over the nose. And this side, I just pat it and then tap it into my skin. So I don't know if they'll actually look different. They look pretty much the same. But yeah, two different ways, two different brushes. All right, next I'm just gonna do my brows. I have a video for that, so I'm gonna do it off camera. Okay, and then to just clean up my brows with concealer. I know a lot of people do their brows first, then their eyes, so that they can conceal before, but sometimes it just happens like that. I'm using an e.l.f. concealer brush, actually. Looks like this. And I just take a little bit of product and clean up. Looks crazy, but I'm gonna blend it. And then I just honestly use my finger, because then it kind of blends it out but mixes the shadow with it. I don't like an intense under eyebrow highlight, so this is just my jam, okay? And then I'm just taking this Morphe B33 brush. I used to use it for my under eye, but I use it for this now. And I just take some powder and set that. And then just to make sure it's seamlessly blended, I go back with this fluffy brush in my crease. And yeah, that's it. That's all you need. So I'm gonna apply lashes and a lip, and I'll be back. Okay, so this is our final look. Using brushes I feel like are essential and just can get the job done. I mean, this isn't like an everyday look, and I used like three brushes on my eyes, so I feel like it's unnecessary to have a ton of brushes. Just get the ones that are gonna get the job done. I mean, I use these every single day with any look, no matter how intense or how natural. So I mean, it just goes to show you don't need a crap ton of brushes to get the job done. So yes, thank you so much for watching. You guys are amazing, and like I always say, please subscribe and share. It means the world to me. And let me know what you guys want to see in the comments. And yeah, thank you so much. I'll see you in my next video.